recall that when we classify epithelial tissue, we classify it based on the number of layers. So that's either simple or stratified. And then the shape of the cell at the apical surface. And so those shapes can be squamous, cuboidal, or columnar. Let's go through each of the classifications of epithelial tissue. Simple squamous epithelial tissue is a single layer of flat cells. It's very delicate tissue, and its function is to facilitate the diffusion of small molecules. So we find simple squamous epithelial tissue in the air sacs. They compose your alveoli. Those are the air sacs in your lungs. They're very delicate, and it's across the wall of the alveolus that oxygen diffuses into your body and CO2 diffuses out. We also find simple squamous epithelial tissue lining blood vessels. And so at the capillary level, where you only have that single layer of cells, diffusion of molecules is facilitated. We also find this tissue lining the membranes of the body, so serous membranes, which line body cavities as well as the surface of organs on the outside surface. So this tissue is very delicate and very fine. Stratified squamous epithelial tissue, on the other hand, is very sturdy and durable. It's many layers of those flat, scale-shaped cells. And so it provides incredible protection against stressors. Possible stressors are mechanical stressors. Other stressors like pathogenic, so bacteria, viruses. Also, chemical stressors like UV light. So we find this tissue where a lot of stress is experienced. So starting with the skin on your epidermis, you experience a lot of stressors. And so we find this type of tissue lining your skin, your epidermis. In fact, that tissue is keratinized. And we're going to get to that when we discuss the integumentary system. We also find this tissue lining the mouth and the esophagus. We also find this tissue lining the rectum and the vagina. So wherever there's a lot of mechanical stress, you'll find stratified squamous epithelial tissue. Simple cuboidal epithelial tissue always forms these rings. So when we see it, we're going to always see this like white ring in the middle. And it's around that white ring that those cuboidal cells form some sort of tube. So they're inside your body. They're not really lining the surface or lining an organ, but they're forming these delicate tubes. For example, the kidney tubule is this very long, convoluted tube in your kidneys that is the site of reabsorption and secretion of molecules in the formation of urine. So they actively secrete and they're actively absorbing. Stratified cuboidal epithelial tissue is two layers of those cube-shaped cells. And you find this tissue forming many glands in your body, sweat glands, mammary glands, salivary glands. And so these cells are actively secreting and, of course, protecting. The overarching theme of epithelial tissue is certainly protection. Simple columnar epithelial tissue is composed of those tall column-shaped cells. And it's interesting when you see this tissue because all of the nuclei line up at the basal surface of that entire layer. And they sort of look like little soldiers lined up very, very perfectly against one another. You find this tissue primarily lining the stomach and the small and large intestine. This is where you have a lot of secretion and absorption, and of course, protection. Stratified columnar epithelial tissue, while relatively rare, is composed of two layers of columnar cells. The basal layer kind of appears a little bit cuboidal, but it's that top layer, remember, that we always use to classify this tissue. And so that apical layer of cells is most definitely columnar in shape. We find this tissue, as I said, it's relatively rare in the body in a portion of the male urethra. Pseudostratified columnar epithelial tissue, it's probably my favorite tissue. It lines much of the respiratory tract, the nose, the trachea, and because of its location, it bears these neat little structures called cilia. A lot of the time it does. And those cilia beat and move. And because this tissue is moist due to the mucus produced by the underlying mucosal glands, any kind of inhaled debris gets trapped in that sticky surface, and those cilia function to sweep away that debris so that it doesn't continue into your respiratory tract, deep into your lungs. The final epithelial tissue is transitional epithelial tissue. It lines much of your urinary system, so the urinary bladder, the ureters. This tissue is particularly suited to accommodate a stretch and recoil, the sort of constant active process that's occurring along the wall of your urinary bladder as it fills with urine and then it releases urine, and it fills with urine and releases. And so it's particularly suited for that distension, which means like a stretch action along the wall of that organ. So be sure you are familiar with the way each of these tissues look. Of course, the name, where you would find this tissue, very specific description of the structure, as well as the function.